Welcome one and all to the 2020 Grosvenor Park Church of England Academy Christmas performance. What a unique 12 months we have had, and it is almost unbelievable, but at the same time, very exciting that we have now reached this very special time of the calendar.
Although it is not yet possible for parents to visit the inside of our school, our building is looking as festive as ever, with Christmas trees, presents and Rudolph jokes seemingly everywhere. For this year's service, each class has put together a short routine that we very much hope you'll be able to see live next time. So open up the mince pie tin.
Pop on your favourite Christmas jumper.
And enjoy the show.
In the beginning, Adam and Eve lived in the Garden of Eden. They had all they wanted, but there was only one rule in their lives. God had told them not to eat the fruit from one of the trees in the garden, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. But one day, Adam and Eve disobeyed God, so God said,
"Look, the human beings have become like us, knowing both good and evil. What if they reach out, take the fruit from the tree of life and eat it? Then they will live forever." So the Lord God banished them from the Garden of Eden, and he sent Adam out to cultivate the ground from which he had been made.
After sending him out, the Lord stationed mighty cherubim to the east of the Garden of Eden. He placed a flaming sword that flashed back and forth to guard the tree of life. But now there is another way. Jesus tells us he is the way, the truth, and the life.
Bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell time and jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air. What a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away. Go gliding in the one horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling feet. That's the jingle bell rock. Gliding in the one horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling feet. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell rock.
Prophecies of Jesus coming. Hundreds of years before Jesus was born, the prophet Isaiah told of his birth. The Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and will call him Emmanuel.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For unto us a child is born, for unto us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. His reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness. From that time on and forever, the zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
Next. Nay.
No, you need to go with that line over there, you silly.
How do you spell that?
It says operation.
We've still got 1 hour to lunch. But I'm starving. Why can't we have lunch now?
Get back to work, you lazy swines. We've got to count all these people in the next 2 days.
How are the four of us going to do that?
There's too many. Can't we just have a guess?
Yeah, I guess that's about 24. Let's go get lunch. Listen, you're not going anywhere until we've got all these people counted. Get on with it.
What got him excited?
I know you think he was Caesar.
I meant to Caesar much shorter than you'd think.
Why did they give me the laziest soldiers around here? I just needed someone who could do an easy job.
Boss, what comes after XBI?
XBII, dummy.
If I lose count, can I go home?
Why do I have to do this? Too much stress.
The angel visits Mary. 700 years after the prophecies of Isaiah, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favoured, the Lord is with you."
Mary was gently troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, you have found the favour of God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will call him Jesus. He will be great and he will be called the Son of the Most High. But Lord God will give him the throne to his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descent forever. His kingdom will never die."
"How will this be, Mary?" asked the angel, "since I'm a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. I'm the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." And then the angel left her.
Jesus is born. At the time, Emperor Augustus ordered census to be taken throughout the Roman Empire. Everyone then went to register themselves, each to his own hometown.
Joseph went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to the town of Bethlehem in Judea, the birthplace of King David. Joseph went there because he was a descendant of David. He went to register with Mary, who was promised in marriage to him.
She was pregnant, and while they were in Bethlehem, the time came for her to have her baby. She gave birth to her first son, wrapped him in clothes, and laid him in a manger. There was no room for them to stay in the inn.
Reach engine 4, down the corridor and to the left.
What name is your name, Book Dunder?
I'm sorry, we're fully booked.
No, we don't have breakfast in bed.
Wow, it's busy.
I know, I haven't stopped all day.
Before, if someone putting people in the corridors, one could be sweeping in the cleaning cupboard.
You'd think people would book a room beforehand, had they ever used TripAdvisor.
I had to turn away another couple. The lady was pregnant. I felt just awful.
I think they came to me too. I had to send them away too.
Yep, they came here too.
I think they're the ones sleeping in the barn. Lovely couple.
The barn? You can't put a pregnant lady in a barn.
What about all the animals?
Yeah, where are the animals going to sleep?
Better in the barn and out on the street.
Did you at least clean up first?
Gross.
Where are all the animals sleeping?
I'm sure they will have a very peaceful night. They both seem very relaxed.
Shepherds hear the good news, and there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace to those who his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into the heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in a manger.
How could such small
presence smells so loud.
Isn't it his turn to watch the sheep?
Yeah, wake him up.
Hey, wake up.
Has anyone counted the sheep yet?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Did I count you?
There's 47 sheep.
Hey, wake up.
How do you know there's 47?
Well, there's 10 there, 8 there, and 22 there. That's 47.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I must count again.
I can't get him to wake up.
Shake him. Poke him.
Throw water on him.
Wake up!
Whoa, no need to shine that light in my eye.
What light?
Did you see that light?
Who's that?
Maybe they can count the sheep for us.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where's the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and we've come to worship him."
When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people, chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, but are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out you will become a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel."
Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him."
Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over by the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed on coming to the house. They saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him.
I told you to ask for a direction, you dingus.
I don't need directions. I know exactly where we are.
Well, clearly you don't. You said that 3 hours ago.
Guys, calm down. The camels need to rest again, and I can't control that.
The camels need to rest again. I need to rest! Look, just give me the map, you donut.
No way. I'm the navigator and I will find the right way.
Where are we on this map anyway?
We're somewhere between somewhere and I have no idea, so no.
Do we all remember to bring a gift? No names.
What gift?
Did you forget to bring a gift again?
I'm going to go check on my bag.
Guys, I have a teeny weeny peeny problem. I forgot the bananas, but I bring apples and I forgot the gift.
You can't be a king without a gift.
What did you guys bring anyway?
Some gold, some incense, and a yo-yo.
A yo-yo? The king's riches probably has a billion of them. I've got it left at the next sand dune.
You have no clue. You said there would be clear directions. There must be a sign somewhere.
Guys, look, that's a huge star.
Whoa, star of wonder, star of light, star of all, you'll burn my eyes.
Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon, who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple courts.
When the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what the custom of the law required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you may now dismiss your servant in peace, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all nations, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel.
The children's father and mother marveled at what was said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, this child is destined to cause the falling and raising of many in Israel and to be signs that will be spoken against, so that thousands of hearts will be revealed and the sword will pierce your own soul too.
It's so busy.
I know, these humans are everywhere.
I've been walking for days and I just want a nice table to relax in.
These humans are starting to give me the hump.
Look at that one, doesn't even have a clue where he's going.
And he's got a fat lady with him.
They're my people, and she's not fat, she's got a baby.
A baby? Why is the baby under a dress?
Did she eat the baby?
Why would she eat the baby?
No, she's pregnant. I carried her here.
Wow, that must hurt.
Why are they all here?
I heard one human say they need to count all the toes.
I don't have toes, I have hooves.
They're counting all the people to see how many there are.
Why?
No idea.
My human said it was because their king was coming.
Ooh, a king in my stable. How exciting.
The true light in the beginning was a word, and that word was with God, and that word was God. He was with God in the beginning, without him. All things were made without him. Nothing was made that has been made. In him was life. And that life was the light of mankind. And the light shined in the darkness, and in the darkness shined the light, and has overcome it.
There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gave light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him.
Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believe in his name, he gave the right to become a children of God. Children born of nature, descent or not of human decisions, or a husband's will, but not of both. The world became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father full and grace and truth.
Every year we remember the birth of this child, a boy called Jesus, whose life changed the world forever. This boy grew to be a man of many different names, Christ, Son of God, Saviour, the World Lamp of God, Light of the World, Yeshua, Ice, Prince of Peace, Emmanuel, God with us.
Love and understanding. Merry Christmas.
shops.
We get lost on the way to relatives.
We get stressed over little things.
We eat too much, we sleep too much, and we watch too much TV.
We need to remember.
That's a long time ago.
In a little city in Bethlehem,
a mother and father looked over a little baby.
A special baby.
When you could change the world,
if we could slow down.
And remember them,
maybe Christmas wouldn't be as stressful.
If we remember that little baby,
and who he was,
then maybe our Christmas
would be as peaceful as that first one.
Merry Christmas.
And a happy new year.
9 months before Christmas and all through the town, was locked down in Britain, UK feeling down. Could not go to Primark and there's no more loo rolls. Lots of emotions go to and fro. 8 months till Christmas, still waiting at home, whilst NHS workers still having to roam. And my friend on their Samsung and me on my phone, called until 8 playing Minecraft alone. 5 months till Christmas, we're all feeling stress. This isn't that great, fun getting much less. 3 months till Christmas, no more lockdowns, the current restrictions still making us frown. 2 months till Christmas, COVID still near us, obsessed with Among Us, it caused such a fuss. We're now in the classroom, then isolation meant doom. 1 week till Christmas, chocolate for the class, Santa still coming to homes en masse. Merry Christmas to all, a new hope is near. From all of us at school, we wish you a happy new year. Let us pray.
Dear Father, we ask that you bless our school. May everybody feel that they belong here. Help us all to believe in God and ourselves. With the help of each other, may we all become the best that we can be. Let every voice be heard. In Jesus' name, Amen.